story.
On a much, much lighter note, it was a big weekend for Korean pop sensation Psy following his live performance on the Plaza on Friday. I leave for one day. And look what happened.
I was going to say, you know, Matt, I think you weren't here because you were worried your invisible horse dance wasn't up to snuff.
I was worried that I was going to have to do that. And I watched some video of you guys doing it. Meanwhile, he had a very big weekend.
He did. He made a surprise appearance on SNL's season debut. His single has now climbed to number one on the iTunes chart. So this morning, as promised, he will have a special message for his fans.
We'll get to that a little later on. Let's take a breath, though, and start with a very serious story, the ongoing anti-American violence in the Middle East.
But first, this is Today on NBC. Gangnam Style. 7:30 now on this Monday morning, September 17th, 2012. Psy had us dancing Gangnam Style here on Friday. Then he popped up on SNL over the weekend, and now he can lay claim to the hottest single in the country, number one on iTunes. We're going to hear from him on that big accomplishment coming up. Inside Studio 1A, I'm Savannah Guthrie alongside Matt Lauer, who's decided it is safe to return now that Psy is not here doing the Gangnam Style dance.
It looked like a lot of fun, I have to admit. I watched your moves.
Yeah,
it looked like a lot of fun, I must admit.
I was going to say, I'm sorry you weren't there, because if you had been, then you would have been the one with the least rhythm instead of me.
Exactly, and there would have been tape of that forever. So anyway, also ahead, we've got an interesting take on the current unrest in the Middle East. Coming up, we're going to talk to Salman Rushdie, whose novel more than 20 years ago made him the target of similar anger and death threats. And we're going to get his perspective on this situation in just a couple of minutes. I can just tell you myself, my children will not be in the enclosure.
Let me hug it. Just ahead, big news for Psy after his breakout performance on our Plaza.
You missed one heck of a show out here on the Plaza. We all went Gangnam Style.
Yes.
Here we are trying to dance. Oh, my goodness. Burn the tape.
Look at David Gregory.
I know.
He did that during Meet the Press.
I know, it's true. And the ratings skyrocketed.
That was a little combination of Gangnam Style from David and an Irish folk dance, I think. I'm not exactly sure, but good for him for getting out there and trying it.
Well, because of this breakout performance out on the Today Show, Psy actually went to number one on iTunes, a huge moment for him, and he actually recorded a little message for us.
From last Friday, Today's Show, singing twice, is climbing like crazy, and now, first time in history. Can I cry? Maybe a little bit? What can I say? Unbelievable. Only because of the Today Show, I'm on it, and I'm in it. Thank you so much.
Oh, we're so happy for him.
That's nice.
And when people saw us dancing, they wanted to cry.
Yes.
We're very happy for Psy.
He completely shafted Saturday Night Live there, didn't he? Because it was only the Today Show that put him over the top.
Well, I don't know. We had to go back and do the forensics on the timing.
Right.
Did he hit number one before Saturday Night Live or after?
I think so.
All right, cool.
Just be careful.
Just turn around.
We'll get back to you on that. We'll get back to that. That was from Katie Kelly.
That guy back there wants to see.
You know what they do
since
on YouTube
we didn't
videos.
See Matt Gangnam Style last Friday, does he know how to do it? Yes.
We're waiting for the OU band.
Some of these questions are some of these questions I think were like advice columnists. How can I politely ask my mom to stay in a hotel during her visit? Our house is too small and her criticizing is too much.
Change the locks.
Ohio University, of course, Matt's alma mater, so he'll take all the credit for that performance.
Marching 110, most entertaining band in the land, Natalie.
I think they need to be here on the Plaza and you doing little Gangnam stuff.
How many hints can we send to you?
Call them in.
Is that it?
Sure. Mr. Roker got it.
All right, let's do this.
I'll do it.
All right, okay. You heard it.
Show out here on the Plaza. We all went Gangnam Style.
Yes.
Here we are trying to dance. Oh my goodness, burn the tape.
Look
anyway,
at David Gregory.
I know.
He did that during Meet the Press.
I know, it's true. And the ratings skyrocketed.
That was a little combination of Gangnam Style from David and an Irish folk dance, I think. I'm not exactly sure, but good for him for getting out there and trying it.
Well, because of this breakout performance out on the Today Show, Psy actually went to number one on iTunes, a huge moment for him, and he actually recorded a little message for us.
From last Friday, Today's Show, singing twice, is climbing like crazy, and now, first time in history. Can I cry? Maybe a little bit? What can I say? Unbelievable. Only because of the Today Show, I'm on it, and I'm in it. Thank you so much.
Oh, we're happy for him.
It's nice.
And when people saw us dancing, they wanted to cry.
Yes.
We're very happy for Psy.
He completely shafted Saturday Night Live there, didn't he? Because it was only the Today Show that put him over the top.
Well, I don't know. We had to go back and do the forensics on the timing.
Right.
Did he hit number one before Saturday Night Live or after?
I think so.
All right, cool.
Just be careful.
Just turn around.
We'll get back to you. You look like a lot of fun, I have to admit. I watched your moves.
Yeah,
it looked like a lot of fun, I must admit.
I was going to say, I'm sorry you weren't there, because if you had been, then you would have been the one with the least rhythm instead of me.
Exactly, and there would have been tape of that forever. So anyway, also ahead, we've got an interesting take on the current unrest in the Middle East. Coming up, we're going to talk to Salman Rushdie, whose novel more than 20 years ago made him the target of similar anger and death threats. And we're going to get his perspective on this situation in just a couple of minutes. I can just tell you myself, my children will not be in the enclosure.
Let me hug it.
Just ahead, big news for Psy after his breakout performance on our plaza.
On a much, much lighter note, it was a big weekend for Korean pop sensation Psy following his live performance on the plaza on Friday. I leave for one day. And look what happened.
I was
going to
say, you know, Matt, I think you weren't here because you were worried your invisible horse dance wasn't up to snuff.
I was worried that I was going to have to do that. And I watched some video of you guys doing it. Meanwhile, he had a very big weekend.
He did. He made a surprise appearance on SNL's season debut. His single has now climbed to number one on the iTunes chart. So this morning, as promised, he will have a special message for his fans.
All right, we'll get to that a little later on. Let's take a breath, though, and start with a very serious story, the ongoing anti-American violence in the Middle East.
But first, this is Today on NBC. Open Gangnam Style. 7:30 now on this Monday morning, September 17th, 2012. Psy had us dancing Gangnam Style here on Friday. Then he popped up on SNL over the weekend, and now he can lay claim to the hottest single in the country, number one on iTunes. They're going to hear from him on that big accomplishment coming up. Inside Studio 1A, I'm Savannah Guthrie alongside Matt Lauer, who's decided it is safe to return now that Psy is not here doing the Gangnam Style.